Okay, there we go. It's a bit pricey.
Yeah, I figured it was a little bit expensive. You know, you're not going to get deals from government, I'll tell you that.
Definitely not.
How much are these proofs normally, like, priced at, like, $12, $15, or?
Well, usually they're about, yeah, like, about that price. I mean, I've gotten some for about $8 when I'm lucky.
That's good.
I always try to go with, like, the bulk deals, anything that's 20 or more coins.
Mm-hmm.
So what else is going on? I see YouTube is a little slow.
Not much.
The RAM designs. I like that 100 for 100 RAM design.
I saw that RAM. Oh, Silvertowne got 3 of them.
Yeah, it's a pretty good design, in my opinion. One of the best, even though that, what is it, Year of the Goat?
Yeah, started. Year of the Goat, Sheep, and Ram, whatever you choose. I guess the Canadian Mint is going with the Ram.
Yeah, it's a nice coin. It's just spending $100 on an ounce of silver. I don't know.
That's hard, right? Everybody says the same thing, but like, if you like it, you go for it, you know?
Yeah, right now I'm trying to rebuild this, you know, start the stack up again, stop doing the numismatics for a while.
You going back with the bars and stuff?
Yeah, I'm actually, did you see the Silvertowne bars? The ones they have with, what was it, the Buffalo? That's only out for 1 month?
Oh, really? I didn't know that. Is it from Silvertowne.com?
Yeah. They're only going to have the bar out for 1 month, and you can engrave the back if you want. And it, I think right now it's free shipping, only 23 something.
And what do you engrave on the back? Anything you want?
Yeah, anything you want. Like, I guess if you want to put your YouTube channel or whatever, it's like $5 extra.
Oh.
It might be nice to get some for giveaways.
Right, and put Mr. Vegeta on the back, or you can put Brian the Log on the back.
Yeah, good promotional items. A little expensive, but hey, $28 ain't bad.
Right, and it's free shipping. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, they have that. Then the new design. I want to pick up some Silvertowne stuff. They're pretty reasonably priced, you know.
Yeah, they have the check price too now. They didn't offer this before, so you save a little if you want to spend by check. I remember you bought those 5-ounce little cord bars.
Yes.
Those are really nice. Like, everybody will buy it. Like, you can sell it to Atmex, Provident, whoever you want. They'll buy that back, you know, like... I don't know if Atmex would want to buy Provident metal bars, you know, and vice versa.
Yeah, but Silvertowne, everyone buys.
Right. I don't want to say it's a generic brand, but it's a brand that everybody just, you know, accepts. Like the A-Mark bar too, Johnson Matthey and Engelhard are higher premium. Yeah, looking for the cord bar. I can't find it. There it is.
Silvertowne cord bar on eBay. I might want to get one of those 5 ounces.
I still don't have any of those cord bars, so I figure maybe I'll get one. I also like the one from Scottsdale. I like those port bars too.
Yeah, those are pretty nice. Let me see. There's one Silvertowne port bar going for $117.25 on bid. Only 58 minutes left.
And that's a 5-ouncer?
Yep.
Yeah, that's the same price on the site.
Yeah, if you want to do a buy it now, it's $130.90.
Right, you pay a little more if you do that. It's a check wire price, $118.24.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. I've seen this go down to as low as like 106 or 7.
Yeah, I'm trying to get something off my eBay box, so.
Oh, yeah, you can use eBay box, that's right.
Save a little bit of cash. They got a trademark bald eagle 5 ounce going for $115 with 18 minutes left.
Nice.
It's not too bad. You just got to catch a good bid.
Mm-hmm. You do a lot of buying on eBay?
Yeah, I try to do the eBay stuff, but like when there's 4 times eBay bucks, I'll try to buy coins and stuff.
Okay. Yeah, I only bought silver on eBay through the dealers. I never bought it from some other guy.
Yeah, like whenever I put up something to sell, like the Zombucks, I actually put it under U.S. coins so that people could take advantage of eBay bucks.
Oh, good idea. Yeah.
Plus, I think it helps sell easier because people know they're getting money back. So.
Yeah.
Maybe one day when I decide to sell my bars, I'll go that path too. Instead of
putting the bullion on U.S. coins.
That's right.
Good idea.
You probably could end up selling it for a little more as long as people know they could get like $10 back.
Yeah. I sold a 10-ounce bar just to see as an experiment how much people would bid for it. I think the silver spot price was around $21-$22 at the time. And I had this thing called the eBay voucher, so like I didn't pay any fees, but I just get credit on my account and use that money towards another purchase. So I left it at no reserve, and somebody bought it for like $253, 10-ounce bar. So I got the whole $253, and I spent it on other things. So that was kind of cool because... You get the whole retail value of it. Excuse me.
Yeah, that's not bad at all.
Yeah, I like that way because then you can exchange your bars for some other silver or gold. Hey, Brian, did you hear about this Britannia sale on Gainesville yesterday?
No, I did not.
I particularly don't like Britannia, so like I wouldn't buy it even if it's on sale. Unless it's like way under spot, that's a different story.
I was looking at buying some the Britannia with the privy mark on the edge. Those kind of look cool.
That might be more of a numismatic value there. Yeah, for some reason, people like the privy.
Yeah, I don't know, like, buying, but the Canadian stuff, I'll probably stick to that better than anything. Let me see here. Package detail. Trying to get some discounted price on postage here on eBay.
Yeah, you get a little off. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's not bad. I'm going to do some, like... a 10-ounce package, even though it's like 6 ounces. Mm-hmm. 'Cause last time my package got sent back, I was pissed off. Let's see right now. Let's see, watch. Let's see. So are there any good other good deals going on? I've been seeing the a lot of people talking about the Kennedys.
Yeah, Kennedys is pretty a hot coin topic right now. You remember the reverse proof gold buffalo that came out last year?
Yes, I do.
So I think the Kennedy coin is in that same realm. You know, but we have to wait till the fall for the silver coins.
That's a bummer.
Yeah. I thought they would all get it, you know, at the same time, but no.
I kind of have a theory about that, Mr. V.
Yeah, I think you mentioned that the baseball coins are still backed up so they can't make silver Kennedys. Is that right?
Yeah, my order status for the baseball coins are listed as back ordered, will ship on June the 16th.
Mm-hmm.
Will ship. They didn't even update the back order status as if the 16th was still coming up.
Yeah, mine too. Same thing. Just says June 12th, and I called them. I'm like, did you guys send it? I don't see any package in my house. You know, it's like, what's going on? And they said that, well, you have a second shipment in July, so they'll probably send it together. I'm like, oh.
Well, yeah, my second shipment date was for the uncirculated on July 3rd. Now, granted, it was a holiday weekend, so maybe.
Okay.
Because I bought two of the proofs and two of the uncirculated.
Right.
But I'm all ready to buy. I want to buy at least three of the Kennedys.
Three gold coins or the three silver?
Three gold. I mean, since you're allowed to buy up to five, I'm glad that they put that that limit on there so that people like Silver Siren and 24K can't buy them all up.
I think Brian will load up on the silver Kennedys.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to try to get like four sets of those.
I'll throw a couple of Kennedys in with all the knights, dude.
What's going on here?
I'm the law of king of...
King of the Ikes. Almost.
Still stacking up on those silver Ikes.
Yeah, I'm still stacking up on them. I just, you know, slowed down a bit.
Yeah, I got the 76 proof set that had the Ike along with the 40% diamond 50 cent piece. I picked that up maybe about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Yeah, just try to go with the straight Ikes.
Move in.
That was easy. Slow day, huh? Everybody's out today still.
Could be, you know, because of the holidays, might not be here or whatever.
Yeah, that's why I think, like, YouTube is slow, too. Like, everybody disappeared for July 4th.
Not many videos from everyone.
Yeah, I've been Instagramming it recently. A lot more action up on there.
Did you get the Black Rhino coin or no?
No, I stayed away from that.
There's only 14 left.
Yeah. Well, if I want it, I'll get it eventually.
You can check eBay. I think some of them are selling it, so...
Yeah, but I think I'm going to do some, like, bullion purchasing right now. Like I said, I've been doing numismatics pretty heavy, so.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's a good time to, I think, at least because of the increase in spot silver. Because I think silver is going to taper back down again.
What's the price now?
So the 21 and a quarter.
Okay.
Yep. I mean, I jumped on that Atmex deal about just over a month ago. They found those silver Mexican Libertads with the shipping. I paid $22.04 for each of the 21 Libertads I bought. They were all 2012s.
That's a good deal.
Nice.
That was a sweetheart deal. I loved it. And they sent the 20 of them in the original Banco de Mexico roll.
Oh, cool. So it's just like a fresh roll.
I took the one that they had in a flip and I threw it in an airtight so I had it to look at.
Right.
Yeah, I gotta get some Libertads. I was looking at buying a 2 ouncer.
I tell you something to kind of keep vigilant on is the 2014 silver Libertad. They're supposedly going to be released within another week or so.
Mm-hmm.
That is a very late coming coin for a bullion. For a common bullion coin from Mexico, I'm thinking.
Well, what's the problem? I mean, it's already half the year is over.
Over half the year. I don't know what the deal is. It's kind of crazy. There was no real explanation given.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm wondering, I mean, that might be a very low mintage year. It might be worth picking up a roll.
How about the proofs? Are they going to make those too, or...
Well, they have a proof set out now. It has all the, I think it starts from 2 ounce and 1 ounce and then goes down to the fractionals.
Okay.
Silver Siren has one of those sets, I believe.
That's from this year or last year?
This year, I believe. The 2014 Silver Proof Set Siren.
Where'd you get that from?
I hope I'm not mixing up. No, I'm talking about the Libertad Silver Siren. You got the 2014. Okay. I might be mixed, crossing gears here.
They have the 2013 on Atmex.
I think the 2014 is an exclusive from one or two dealers.
Oh.
Yeah, story I read, it was mixed in with the Kennedy release story on Coin Weekly or whatever that site is.
I gotta find that out because I do like the proof Libertad.
Now they're
fairly low mintage too, right? So.
Oh yeah. They had the gold Libertads out since March.
Hmm.
Silver ones were on hold.
I wonder, a lot of the silver stuff for this year is being put on hold, or it's like very difficult to get out.
Yeah, I mean, it's getting interesting. I mean, the Kennedy silvers, I mean, weren't they originally slated for July, and now they're pushed back to the fall? And then, you know, Mr. V and myself waiting for the silver baseball coin. So it makes me wonder if there's enough processed silver around.
Enough blanks for it?
Yeah, enough silver blanks.
Maybe they're harder to make the curved blanks. I don't know.
Yeah, but that still wouldn't, explain the silver Kennedys.
That's true, because those are flat, right?
Yeah. They're going to do, different finishes, but that can't be too hard.
I just think it's interesting that the set's going to have every single mint mark.
That could be why it's holding it up too. You got to do it from every different mint, and then put it all together for a coin, and then package it up. So that might be taking a little longer. I don't know.
Yeah, I can imagine the logistics with that.
But I mean, they say they make each one at each different mint, but they could just have the dyes at one mint and do it all in one place. We wouldn't know the difference.
That's true.
That stuff, you know, they're never going to tell us that stuff. They probably have it like at West Point Mint, all the dyes for each mint, and just do it right there.
The Denver Mint is not really known for making silver coins in as far as modern silver coins. Most of the modern silver coins were between San Francisco, Philadelphia, and West Point. The Eagles, for example. There's no such thing as a Denver Eagle, I believe.
Very true. It'll be interesting when it comes out. They're probably, I hope it's like a certain mintage, though, like not just unlimited.
I cannot see it being unlimited, particularly because of the special, well, I really, I don't know. I mean, they always have silver rounds to make the 50-cent pieces for the mint sets every year. But, like, for example, the 2013 silver dimes and the silver 50-cent pieces are likely sleepers because they have low mintages relative to the Eagles and the Quarters.
Yep. That's very true. That's why I got two 2013 mint sets, the silver ones, before they sold out. I always check the mintages. And you start kicking yourself when you're like, damn, I should have bought a couple.
Yeah. Silver Siren and I bought those limited edition silver sets. He bought, I think, like four of them, and I bought three. They have the 50-cent piece and a dime as well.
Yeah, those are nice, but, I mean, what, 50,000 mintage? To get the quarters are everywhere, so those aren't really that rare. It's just that being all together makes it rare, I guess.
You know, the funny thing is, if you send it into the grading companies, they have a special slab for that. And if you look at eBay for the 2013 limited edition silver set half dollar, the 69s and 70s are selling for hundreds of dollars. Crazy.
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense. Like, there's no difference between those halves and then the ones that came in the 14-piece set. So people are just getting, you know, the wool thrown over their eyes.
Yeah, it could be grading hype.
Well, listen, after what happened to you guys with the Crocs and the grading stuff, I knew something was up. I was like, man, this grading stuff has to stop.
Yeah, I don't think I'm doing any modern graded coins. I have a couple pandas, a 13 and a 14, that were slabbed and graded. Mm-hmm. I bought them that way. But, I mean, aside from that, I don't own any graded coins other than my old 50-cent pieces, and that's just a way to make sure that they're not counterfeit. Because, I mean, those things are expensive. I want to make sure it's not some fake coin sentiment. A bit of assurance.
I have nothing against the modern graded stuff if it's done right, you know. But like, I had the problem with my Kiwi coin that it definitely had a mark on it, but yet they still graded a 70. I was like, well, who graded this?
Yeah, that was unfortunate.
And that was an NGC, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. Somebody have a monkey in the background?
I hear that too.
You guys have pet monkeys all of a sudden?
Nah, the pet monkeys are in the other hangout running right now.
I think I only hear the monkey when Brian's talking.
Uh-oh. I don't got any monkeys here.
I don't hear no monkey. I want to hear it.
It's It's like right when Brian starts talking and right when he finishes.
Damn monkeys. Cyber monkeys.
Mm-hmm. I looked at my croc coin yesterday with a loop. And yep. I saw some dings on the inner ring, but the rest of the coin was fine. Then I looked at like my raw, regular croc that's not graded, right? And the ungraded ones have more dings and scuffs and marks. So what they did was they said, let's take the least amount of errors and make that a perfect 70. They call it what's called a production error or production flaw. And I emailed an eBay seller who's selling the PCGS crocodile. So I asked him if these have, you know, errors or knickknacks or whatever is on the coin. And he didn't say yes or no, but he tried to explain that we do our best to sell the most, you know, nicest coin, but there could be an issue with production flaws at times, and we cannot guarantee that. So I'm like, oh, I'm getting the phone call. I'll be right back.
All right. But based off that, I mean, then nothing should be graded 70. If you see nicks and marks, even if they're production, it doesn't deserve to be a 70 because it's not perfect. It should have nothing wrong with it, production or not, you know.
Yeah, I think that's right. I mean, look at silver dollars. How many 70 silver dollars are there? Probably none.
Yeah, I mean, that would make the 70s, I would think, more expensive if you found a croc that had no dings, nothing wrong with it, and then there were, what, maybe 100 of them made like that? How expensive would those things get?
Yeah, and deservedly so.
Yeah, but I don't know. These grading companies, they're starting to get a little crazy. Let me see something.
Agent was saying that he worked at one time for NGC as a grader.
Really? NGC? I thought it was PCGS.
I'll be right back, guys.
Well, one of them. I was thinking it was NGC.
Maybe it was. I don't know. Sylvia, what's your next purchase going to be?
A Hawaiian vacation.
Yeah.
Some people are holding off because there have been so many interesting coins they're trying to get, and they don't have any more money.
Well, I do plan on getting about 10 of the new Zombucks.
Okay.
Just keep my sets going, you know, I've got some of each, so I don't know if they'll be worth more as a set when the series is over or not.
As long as the zombie culture is in demand and people like it, you know.
You know,
if you're going to sell it during Halloween, like right before Halloween.
I mean, no rhyme or reason, but I kind of get a vibe that the zombie genre is going to be overplayed over the next year. It's just been going on for like 3 or 4 years.
How many more of those coins are they going to come out with?
They're supposed to have 10 altogether, I believe, so this is 5 of 10.
Okay.
Yeah, it's going to take another... the last one will come out like November... 2015.
So, one more year, a little over a year, okay. Five more coins in a year and a half, or less than.
Something like that.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to go for the Kennedy Gold or no? That's a tough one.
How much they overprice it on the premium, huh?
Well, it's 0.75 and not 1 ounce.
Right.
So I'm thinking somewhere around $1,300, maybe a little more.
Wow.
No, they charge that for a whole ounce silver eagle.
Right. So they if they want to make a lot on the premium of the Kennedy coin, maybe $1,250, $1,300, that's what I'm thinking.
So they're making the gold coin the same size as a half dollar, so that's why it's going to have more than a half ounce of gold?
It's got to be sized differently, because I don't know what the weight would be if it was molded the same way.
It might be thicker. I don't know.
No, it might be thinner because it's gold. Or it might be not as, you know, the radius might be smaller.
Could be. And this is 4 9s, right?
Yes.
So it's very, very soft gold. I mean, like, you don't want to shake that thing inside the coin case or whatever.
Right.
Yeah. You know, otherwise, it's not going to grade a perfect 70. And I know the people will want to buy the 70 and pay extra $1,000 or $2,000 for it. Just like the Buffalo reverse proof, I think is like $4,000, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah,
it's expensive.
Overpriced, but it's gonna be there, around the same price. Hey, Cyber! Welcome, Cyber.
CCT, what's going on?
His mic is not working yet.
See, I plan on getting some silver Kennedys anyway. Aren't they going to have a proof and a uncirculated silver Kennedy?
Mm-hmm.
That's probably what I would want to get the most of.
Silver Kennedy will be in the fall.
Over here, I don't know if you read it yet, but there's going to be a 5 per household limit on all the Kennedys.
Yeah, even the clad.
Huh. So, in the 4 coin set, is that going to include the gold one?
No.
Just all 4 silver coins.
So if you're going to get a 5 maximum per household, then you should probably get just 5 of the 4 coin sets.
Well, I think it's 5 each for each of the...
All right, 5 for each set. Like, if you get 5 of the silvers, if you want 5 of the golds, you could get 5 of the golds as well. It's not 5 between the different metals.
Any news on the time frame? How long are they going to sell this coin for?
I did not see anything, so I'm not sure.
Probably about a month, huh?
I haven't had enough experience with the U.S. Mint as far as how they behave with limited editions. Like that limited edition silver set, they were selling that since December, and they finally sold, they shut it down in April, so that was like 5 months.
Mm-hmm. I hear a train.
Oh, that's my backyard.
Cool.
I have commerce going through.
Hey, what was that U.S. Mint set that you bought? You know, maybe you bought two of. It's like all silver.
Right. That's the U.S. Mint limited edition silver set.
To 2014 or 13?
It's 2013. Byron bought four, but don't talk about it too much with any PC in the room.
Oh, he doesn't like it?
What don't I like?
The 2013 limited edition silver set. I'm trying to keep you from getting, you know, that was a bad experience.
Yeah, the U.S. Mint doesn't like me.
They won't let you buy one? That's not cool.
I don't think it's really them. It's their shipper, UPS. UPS won't send it to me unless I pay them sums of money. Last thing I ordered, they held it hostage. So I told them to go fuck themselves.
That's weird, because I heard other guys buy from Canada, and they didn't have a problem.
Oh, I've bought from U.S. Mint, too, quite a few times, a couple times anyway, at least four times.
I see.
Only the last time they decided they weren't going to give it to me unless I paid them money and signed over power of attorney.
What the hell? That's so weird.
Oh, I remember that video, yes. I was like, what the hell?
Half dollar, it's selling for $165 on eBay right now.
All the 2013 silver set?
Yeah, $165.99, free shipping.
I have to make about, well, after all said and done, I could probably make $15 to $20 then.
Maybe, well, you know, the secondary market could sell out, you know, next year or the year after. You never know.
I think if you look at, I think it was Silvertowne, they were selling them for $159.
Okay.
I think that memory from okay, who is that? You got your YouTube video playing in the back.
I think it's Jim.
Sorry.
I hear my own voice. I hate it.
We're cool now, I think.
Thank you, Jim.
Well, we got a full house now.
Yeah, I'm not sure I want to hear half dollar twice in a row either.
In APC, do be, are you? I nearly choked on my coffee then.
That's not even including videos.
That's what you need to pick up. Yeah, it'll stop me laughing. I'll do that for you, Silverstone. Yeah, you can have this if you want, Silver here. You're more than welcome.
Yeah. I would feel obligated to send you a gold bar or something. What is it? I mean,
so I meant to post this.
I kind of look like him, except he's got more hair.
Yeah, I meant to post it on the 4th of July, but I was elsewhere at the time, so I couldn't. So.
One crown?
Yeah, that's it. 28.28 grams of 925 sterling silver.
That's a nice coin.
I'll flip it off of the cover back in see the reverse. Oh, you can see my window then as well. That's not very good.
The Queen is young.
Yeah, well, she was in 1976.
She's more like a cougar at that point.
If Queen Elizabeth II dies, who would go on the coin next?
Charles, I believe.
Oh, Prince Charles.
Those are going to be some hideous coins.
They should put Kate, not Charles.
They should put Princess Di posthumously.
At that point, and not put
they will never on put her on. But they should.
They, who knows, maybe Great Britain will switch to historical figures.
Was Chiga asking me how much that what crown was?
I guess so.
All right. How much do you think? I'll tell you how much it should have cost. I'll tell you how much it should have cost me.
Oh, $16.
That's it?
Yeah. Oh, you've all seen these. You don't want to see these, do you?
1922. Very old coin.
I'm a dude.
You've all got these, haven't you?
Nice coin.
I think a lot of us got a couple of those.
Morgan coin.
Pretty good condition.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't actually looked at them. Sorry, Silverstone. Taking their blooming pictures. Yeah, I haven't actually looked at them through the loop, but they look all right, don't they?
I guess Silver here had a sweet deal on those.
He bought like 8 of them or something, right?
23.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you were talking about the RCM. There you go. There's a 1989 proof.
Something Mackenzie. Flea Live.
I don't know what it says, actually, because it's backwards on my screen, but...
That's
pretty.
Imagine banjos playing in the background.
Dueling banjos?
Banjos in Canada.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Die on the back.
No, that's Elizabeth, of course. It's the Queen.
It looks like Princess Di.
It's too shiny.
It is very shiny.
It's been cleaned.
It hasn't been cleaned.
Well, that's a fake. Send I'll give it you to the guillotine.
I'll give you a fine.
Oh, you silver hair, Mob Deep will be proud of you right now.
No. I do not want Mob Deep to be proud of me. I failed as a human being.
It's okay. There's room in Canada for you.
digital. What does that mean, Siren? Digital.
Yeah, I saw those rolls on our corporate video. Oh, that one I think I didn't.
Sorry.
Damn these eBay fees.
Yeah, this is the one you wanted to see, Silver Siren, wasn't it? Well, you have seen it, but you want to see it again. Why's my camera so reflective today?
What's with the pictures?
$1.
Is it my lighting?
Dollar.
I'm down my lighting.
The weird queen on the back. Is it?
What's that?
Is that the queen with, or the coin with the weird picture of the queen on the back? I watched your video, and one of them has a picture of a queen that I haven't seen before. She's wearing like a weird TR or something.
You lagged out there in APC.
Yeah, that's the one. I haven't seen that one before.
She has an extra long nose in that one.
She does have a bit of a long nose in that one. I will give you that. But her nose is perfectly all right in this one.
That's from like what, when she was like 20 years old?
Well, it was just after the Queen's Silver Jubilee, wasn't it? 1978. I think she sent a selfie to NAPC.
The Roman Colosseum?
No, that's the hangout. It tells you right there what it is. New Zealand Parliament.
Oh. Yeah, didn't we see that in some movies with hobbits?
I've no idea. Quite amazing condition for their age, though, aren't they, when you think about it?
What the fuck?
Rib joint.
What are you paying, $154
in APC? I'm willing to pay $150. I'm looking at a Morgan right now on eBay. The bidding's at
$70.
Very good condition, 1882-0.
You can have this one for $150 if you like.
I'm guessing this one is either an MS-63 or an MS-64, but it's ungraded.
Dang. Wait a minute. Let me go get mine. What was it? 82-0?
1882-0.
Wait. Let me go see if I've got one. Hang on.
Brian's putting some stuff up.
I can tell you who's definitely got one silver siren.
This one's in pretty good condition. I'm also looking at another 1879S that's MS64 Plus and PCGS, and an 1882CC that looks to be close to MS63, but it's ungraded. CSO has one of everything, at least.
Exactly.
got a bunch of privy reverse proofs there, Brian.
I love my privies.
I got a couple of horse privies.
These are very nice. Damn your pictures.
What's pretty?
Yeah, mob of ruse.
Oh, cool, you got the dragon. Those are like $50.
I think I picked that up for 30-something.
That's a good deal.
Ah, I wondered if that was Brian DeLog. And it is.
It is Brian.
Yes, indeed. With these pictures, Jesus.
When you show good stuff, the camera starts going.
The barber.
The mobile ruse.
That was the copper, right?
Yeah. I just sold my silver once.
Where you got that silver hair?
I got an 1882
L. Whoa. Nice. Very nice. These pictures are for evidence only.
Yeah.
They cannot be used against you in a court of law.
$149 NAPC.
BB price.
For you, $145 free shipping.
That's just as high as I'm willing to go. Right now, she's only at $70.
$70, huh?
Yeah, I can't remember who it was that got me into the Morgans, but...
There's Big Al.
Oh, you got the werewolf up. Hey, NAPC, check out Big Al's screen. I think you were talking about this sometime in the past.
Oh, yeah. That is a nice coin.
Yeah, I was looking at Brian Snake. Sorry, I said that wrong. at the time. And right. I'm looking at the werewolf now.
It's a nice coin.
What is the werewolf coin called? Just the werewolf and that's it?
Yeah.
I think it was Nui.
Oh, the mythical creatures, Palau.
Pavlo?
Not new, it's Palau, yeah.
The Palau, okay.
I think the moon is made out of marble or something like that, or moonstone.
Yeah, it is. It's made out of marble.
Marble, yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah, it's badass.
But they try to do like an antique finish with it.
It's the original antique finish.
But there's two versions or just one?
No, just one, but this is the original antique finish. They did this before the Zeus coin came out, right?
Oh. This is a 2013 coin.
Yep.
They want $400 for it.
For what? Damn. This coin? The werewolf?
Yeah.
I got it for like $179 off eBay.
Yeah, well, this seller wants too much money.
Yeah, that is a pretty awesome coin.
$400, huh?
Yeah, well, let's find something cheaper, huh?
Well, actually, that was one of my favorite films years ago, was An American Werewolf in London. A classic.
Really, I thought that was creepy.
They made that in the 80s, right? The first one?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
They made another one, but I don't think I saw the second one.
Yeah, they did
an American Werewolf in Paris.
Maybe that was it.
Yeah, the werewolf in London was more like a very dark comedy rather than a horror.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Like, hey, I'm your buddy. I'm like all mangled up and I'm just turning more and more into a ghoul. Hey, what's going on?
I'm glad I wasn't the only one that's seen it then.
I mean, it was kind of scary.
Matt has that coin for $278.
It was kind of scary back in the day. I remember that stuff was probably the most suspenseful scene. A wolf stalking the guy in the subway.
What was that, half dollar?
The scene in American Werewolf in London, the subway scene, was probably the most suspenseful one. Stalking him.
Yeah.
Or was it? I think it was a lady in the subway. Yeah,
I can't remember. I just remember seeing the special effects. Well, they were very primitive for the era, but where he changed into a werewolf, I thought it was quite good.
You see my latest Mexican pickups?
I don't know that I did, because I've been away.
Oh, shoot. I even addressed my name in that unboxing. I want to get them and show you.
Mexico. Those are pretty hot Mexican coins right now.
When did you upload it?
Saturday last week.
If I'd have watched it, I'd have left a comment, because I usually do.
Yeah, I didn't see anything, which kind of made me think, did he miss it, or... I can go get him. I got him on the site.
The hell?
Give me a moment. Yeah, this is my train again.
Woo!
Lots of colors.
Is that the gold rue, Brian?
Yes, 2013.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Photo shoot, huh? Let's see, will it focus? Focus. I like the kooks and these mini versions. But I doubt I'll pick any of them up.
The sensible seller there as well. So I'm just looking at that, the werewolf.
That's an error coin. Look at the back of that coin.
What coin?
The werewolf. I put the link in the chat box.
Oh. Yeah.
What's the back supposed to be? It just looks like the surface of the moon.
It does, yeah. And it's not supposed to be like that then.
No. Hey, Big Al, what's the back of the coin supposed to be?
Yeah, I just saw his a minute ago. I wondered if they did two versions.
This is the second version.
What are you guys talking about here?
The werewolf coin? You got the 2013, right?
Yeah, I do.
And what is the back of that coin?
The back of it?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Oh, this one's the 2014.
Right.
It's not the same coin, is it?
Nope. This one's coming at you, attacking you. The other one's howling towards the wolf. I mean, the moon. Oh, it's like a shield. That's a nice back. I like that.
Yeah, the treasure chest. And Dave sitting on his shield.
Would you rather have this back or the arrow that's the surface of the moon?
I think the moon looks pretty good.
Yeah. Well, it's less money, $199.
24Ks is a bit rude. I just saw that.
What's that constellation above the werewolf's head?
Oh, let me see.
It's probably
they just put stars there.
Yeah.
I don't think it's Orion.
No, it's not Orion.
I think I like the werewolf better on 24K's version, though. That is good, yeah. Isn't it?
Kind of like Ozzy's bark at the moon.
It's not the same mint.
Uranus.
You like that, huh? Big Al's coin is not the same as the coin you're looking at on eBay.
Really?
That's correct.
Oh, not the same mint. The one on eBay is a private mint. It's not even got a dollar denomination. It's just an art round.
Oh.
Look what year I got, CCT.
Yeah, yeah. I was just about to leave you a comment there, yeah. So, oh, that looks awesome. That looks that's uncirculated, isn't it?
Which?
I'll go through some of the
half dollars
I got here as well. Here's
Oh, yeah.
Let's see.
59.
Carranza. Yeah.
Fifty-seven.
Yeah.
Here's a pretty cool one. It's a Diaz peso.
Yes, I've seen that one. Yeah. You pick those all up from the LCS?
Actually, Coin Show last week.
Oh, right. Yeah, I must have missed your video because I didn't see them.
49 Onza.
Oh, very nice.
So now I've got a couple odd ones to show you. They're not coins, but they're medallions. First one's from 1963. Recognize the guy on the left side.
Yeah.
Kennedy.
An agreement was signed in 63.
I haven't seen that one before. All of that.
There's an agreement that the U.S. signed with Mexico in 63, I believe. I don't know what the agreement was, but it's a commemorative medallion. I don't think it was from the Mexican Mint. I mean, it was minted in Mexico, but I don't think it was from the Mint. But the heads are really high relief. They pop right out.
Yeah, it looks like it, yeah.
I need to get myself a and then here's the commemorative for take the motto. I think it's a FIFA medallion as well. Board really pops up.
Yeah, I think I might have seen that one from a certain dealer that I use, yeah. But I haven't seen the others.
Really nice mirror finish there.
Very nice.
I don't know, I'm between the owns of and the Diaz peso as far as my favorite from this go-round. Older Mexican, I don't know if the husband was Mexican, but the wife was. And they had binders and binders of old Mexican silver and old world coins.
Right.
And I could have shopped there for probably like another 20 minutes, but I went there with an objective in mind to get some more commemorative 50 cent pieces.
Oh, yeah.
I have some. And then you see these by single peso, 1950 single peso with a train.
Yeah, that's the railroad one. Yeah, that's one I wouldn't mind getting myself. I probably will get the railroad one eventually.
A 48.
Yeah.
What can you tell me about my coin? I need your help.
It's round.
Yeah.
Keep going.
What do you want to know?
Anything, dude. I can't. Is it only limited mintage of 527 and they only sold them in a set? And does that look like a proof coin to you?
Yeah, it does. Yeah. What year is it?
It's a 1990.
Oh, yeah, I can see it. Yeah, I can see it. I just had to tilt my head sideways. I'll look it up for you in a second.
Thank you.
I haven't got my book to hand. Right, I'll go and get my book. I'll be back in a sec. 1990 half-ounce gold.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Didn't break the coins out of the yeah, bro.
What?
You didn't break the coins out of the cases yet?
Oh no, these are staying in these sets. I always like the older years, like the 2000. I collect like two of each, so I could break one open and then keep one. Here I have three 2014 sets and two 2013s.
Yeah, there was a eBay seller. They were selling the 2003 silver proof set. It was for $33, which is a pretty decent price for a full a complete mint set. It's not just the quarters.
But that's buy it now or?
Sorry?
That was buy it now or?
Yeah, it was buy it now.
You should have bought that.
Oh, I did. Yeah, so it was like 33 and I had like $19 in e-bucks. So total bill was like $13.50.
That's a steal.
Yeah. I tell you though, it cost me a small fortune to get those 19 e-bucks.
I should pick up that 1999 set.
Yeah, I gotta shop around for that. That one's a bit expensive.
I have like $40 in e-bucks, so it would still cost what?
100.
$100? I think you could get them for 80. With my ebooks.
Okay. No, one more
coin up again, 24K.
Sorry?
Show me the coin again.
There you go.
What the hell is this?
What's the face value?
£50.
Night now. 1990 proof. Did you say there was 500 and something minted?
Yeah, 527 in sets. And I couldn't find any other information.
Well, it's listing that it is available on its own, or was available on its own, a 1990 proof. And it says
how much was minted?
It says there was 527 minted.
Oh, okay.
And it says it's bullion value plus 5%.
Yeah, I picked it up for... times
15.55, $688. Can you share this? Yeah, I was just about to, Silver Siren. Yeah, I was just about to.
Thank you. All right, guys, I got to run. CCT, thanks a lot.
Okay.
Bye, 24.
All right, buddy.
Can you see that silver siren? Have we got Brian and Silver here trying to match each other?
I don't know. Am I up for a challenge today, maybe?
He's muted himself.
What did you say?
I said, what are you doing?
I'm fixing to take a vacation. I was wondering if I ought to go to this coin shop while I'm there.
The coin shop?
Yeah, let me show it to you.
On a vacation, who the hell? Apple? No one cares about Apple.
Maui coin and jewelry.
Don't come spouting that trash in here. Apple.
Where'd you find that picture then, Mob? Yeah. It's his dad.
Ernie. You know where Ernie is, right?
Hey, Brian.
Yes.
Yeah, can you check out my screen real quick? This is the deal. I bought it yesterday.
Cash for gold, World Coin Shop.
Looks like they sold out of all five.
Hawaii.
So yeah, I bought the one of them.
Interesting.
Got quite a few sets there, Brian.
Yeah. I had more, but I parted them out. You get a lot of these pretty cheap. Part them out and make more money.
Are they the silver-proof sets, or are they the clad?
No, these are all silver.
Ah.
Except for this one.
Was it a low vintage or just a really good price?
Well, the 2013 silver, the 14-coin set, that's low vintage. But I only got to get two of those. And now because of this stupid subscription thing, it's 2014 is going to go over everything's vintage for the past. Which, you know, the Mint did make a smart move using the subscription, but... doesn't help me much.
I think Siren canceled her subscription.
Oh, what's the next sleeper coin? The Arches? You canceled those? Watch them end up selling for like 500 a coin.
I heard Raw Dog bought a monster box because they're going to be selling for $150 each by fall.
I wish I could show you my screen, but somewhere I saw that the bullion versions for these coins of this year only hit 20,000, which shocked me.
Yeah, I think a lot of people were hyped up on the Mount Rushmore and it, you know, the party.
That's what you get for listening to Radha.
Let me pull up. See, I listen to the charts. Let me see if I can pull it up here just to show you numbers. I don't know if you can see it well, though. Jeez. All right, I'm going to try. Can you see that? The Shenandoah National Park stopped at 20,000. I don't know if that's an accurate figure, but that's lower than the P version coin, so I'm wondering if it should be a pickup or not.
Those are just the bullion mintage?
Yep, those are only the bullion mintages. That's why I was kind of shocked to see those numbers, that they're lower than the collector's versions.
Yep.
So maybe it might be good to get a couple monster boxes of those and hold on to them.
Well, you don't want to go all in on that. You don't want to go heavy. One point.
I like to wait more towards the end of the year to see like final numbers, then decide. Coffee. Can I get a cup?
Pretty cool that they got the Southern Cross in that one section.
Yeah, I think it's on the other road sign too.
Got an 1882 O mint mark. That's probably not worth anything, is it?
Well, Silverhair just told me the 1882 O with a MS63 grade is only worth $50 book value. Thing is, I can't find anything for book value. Book value for most uncirculated Morgans is only $30, and I couldn't find a Morgan for $30 to save my life.
Nah.
That's $30.
That's an 1882 there.
It's in pretty good condition, actually.
What
I'm trying to do is to get it from 1878 to 1882, all the coins. But the 1878, there's an 1878 eight tail feather. There's a 7/8 tail feather. There's a 1878 with a 79 back, I think. The 8-tail feather and the 7/8 tail feather in any sort of grade is expensive.
Unless you can come across them accidentally by someone who doesn't know what they're selling.
Yeah, and the 7/8 tail feather, there's like 30 different versions. Then if you get into the VAMs, oh my god.
All right.
Well, I think I've only got, I haven't got many dollars at all.
That's about it, I think. Unless I've got some in storage elsewhere. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Oh, no doubt, you couldn't see them. So not many from the 1800s, is there?
Another monster box coming, empty monster box. That's my big purchase.
How much you pay for an empty monster box?
Sir, what?
How much you buy it for?
Oh, an empty Royal Canadian Mint monster box is like $7.
Oh, okay.
But I bought the 5-ounce Freedom Girl proof like round as well.
Gold, silver bowl.
Yeah. I'm really not a fan of that Chris Wayne thing. I don't trust him, but that I really like that Freedom Girl.
I've got a coin on the way in a PC that you'll like, but I'm not telling you what it is. I'll wait till it gets here.
I have one on the way, too, that you will enjoy, actually. Yeah. It cost me, like, nothing. It was $2.
Oh, really?
I saw it, and I was like, I have to have that.
Yeah, Mum is a bit more than that. Button.
Focus. Where's my control?
Oh, see, you have got a nice dollar in APC.
Yeah, I've got a few. That's an 1878. This is...
I'm just looking to see what Brian's got now.
1878cc.
An old penny.
1943 steel.
Steel penny, man. That's cool.
Found that in some change.
Is 1878 the oldest Morgan coin?
Yeah.
And that's in really good condition.
This is a 79.
It's got the eagle in the back. That's a nice looking coin.
And this is a 1890 CC, which I don't think is a very worth very much for some reason. It must have been the highest minted of the CCs.
I see.
I'm not sure. I'm talking out of my ass right now. But every time I see them, they don't seem to go for very much. I do all my research on coinflation. This is my... I don't know if this is my first Morgan, actually. In 1881.
I don't have any Morgans, at least not yet.
1881 S on circulated.
I have that year, that big mark.
You don't have any Morgans, Mr. V?
No, not one.
There's me. I've got seven, and I'm not even in the United States.
I like the Morgans. Down. I like the circulated ones because you can play with them.
It's nice to have an old coin like that from the history, you know.
Yeah. One of the Aussies, I don't know if it was Cliff Search or Oz. It might have been Cliff Search. He said he liked them because they were cowboy money.
Yeah, reminds me of the old Western films, yeah.
Have a showdown.
Yeah.
Showdown and bet 5 Morgan coins. I wonder how much one of those bought in back in the days. Can you buy like a whole bunch of chickens or sheep with it?
I just imagine them going in and slapping down a Morgan on the bar and ordering fucking 12 sarsaparilla or something, you know?
Yeah.
Sarsaparilla. And sliding it from one end of the bar to the other.
Yes.
Breaking it over someone's head.
What is the most sought-after Morgan dollar? Like, what is the key date for that one?
1891 CC, I think, and 1879 CC, I think.
Okay. I can check my book later.
It's certainly all the Carson City ones, isn't it?
It's also high relief. You want to get some high relief Morgan fees? They're pretty decent, too.
Now, this is my first one, the 1889.
The high relief, that $6 is pretty cheap.
Yeah, there's different versions. Like, there's a couple that have deep mirror planes around the outside. So they look like they're proofs. Must be an S.
Oh, so you got a copper version of the wartime penny as well. Wasn't 44 also a steel year?
I don't know.
I have like three sets of the steel EDS sets.
Let's see if I can get this shitty camera.
What are you doing, Brian?
This loop sucks. This whole design sucks. And that constant flashing of that camera. Thank you. It's killing me. See if I break out some more stuff.
Oh, you got some buffaloes at APC? Didn't you tell me you were looking for some?
Just one. I'm putting together a set of Zombucks and then the coin that they were modeled after.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to try to put them in a nice little display case.
Wow, that's pretty good condition for a barber.
Yeah, it is. It's a barber half. Is it just me, or does the barber half look like a man?
Well, I definitely haven't got any of them.
I think the barber is supposed to still be Liberty. So
yeah,
I think
Liberty.
...1908D, I think.
If the barber's supposed to be a woman, it looks like a tranny. Look at the Adam apple.
A tranny. This is how I got into some of the numismatic stuff, is because of the Zombucks.
Wow, that's a really good condition for a walker as well.
I tried to buy as best as I could afford to put them in the case, because I'm going to turn the Zombucks into a numismatic play by putting the Zombucks in with their numismatic inspiration. I'm putting it in.
Yeah, good idea. Trying to see what Brian's got there. 1910, is that?
Yes, it is. That's the oldest one that I have.
I thought you were going through your change jar.
This is just finding stuff from buying out in the streets.
Brian, you'd love going through my penny collection then. I've been saving pennies since I was like 9. I literally have money bags full.
Oh, boy.
All unsearched.
He's just searching.
Anybody interested in some 1-ounce lunars? First series and the second series rabbit.
Why are you selling?
Yeah.
I'll give you spot price on them.
I don't know. If anyone's interested, let me know.
He just got an offer.
Okay. A spot plus 10%. You need to make a profit.
Are they old notes, Brian?
Well, this one I'm holding says 1976, and it looks like the new ones. No one ever really uses these, so they don't show no wear.
All right.
You should might as well, somebody should just counterfeit these, because people think the real ones are fake anyway.
You ever walk in and just pull one out as a gag to see if somebody gets like a what the hell is that expression on their face?
I've done it a couple times. I've had people actually yell at me and tell me get out of the store. A lot of the younger people, they've never seen this stuff, so I think it's play money.
Yeah, they still make those, you know what? They make them every once in a while. They don't make them every year, but I don't know. I think the last time they made it was 2009.
Yeah, I got a couple 2009s, 2003s.
Yeah, they make them every once in a while. I don't know exactly how it works, but yeah.
I got a 95.
Yeah, I'm more familiar with the Canadian stuff, so.
That's funny.
I'll hold on to them as long as I can.
There you go, half dollar. There's my Carranza.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, there you go. I love that Fu Manchu.
1933.
It's 59.
It has two dates.
Yeah, it's a commemorative, yeah.
Pesos.
CTT, you would have been in heaven at this one stand at the coin show. They had books and boxes of Mexican silver. They even had really small coins. I wasn't sure if they were silver or not, though. They probably were.
I'm very, very jealous.
I'd have loved to have seen that. They just have some great designs, don't they?
They do. I figure in another 3 months, the coin show will be back in town, and I'll go look again.
Did you ever look to see if they had any of those? Did you?
Any what?
Any of those.
I got focused for a sec. I think they did. I think.
But they were pricey.
Yeah, I think I had a little sticker shock, so I passed on it.
Yeah.
And Bob's got some of those.
Has he?
Did the one time.
Do they have any dos pesos? Half dollar?
I don't recall. I was going for so many at a time.
They're always worth picking up as well, because they're pretty scarce, aren't they, Silver Siren? That was one there, in case you missed it.
They had some coins, centavos. I don't know if any of them were silver or not, though. They were like the size of, you know, dime sizes, or some were even just smaller than that. I just don't know if they were silver or not.
No, I can't remember, actually. So I'm just reading the Silver Sun's comment. I still think they should zombify the queen. That would be pretty good. You're telling me the effigy of the queen isn't well known?
How about a zombie Mount Rushmore? Just get all of them creeped out, yeah.
The Queen isn't on any US coins, is she? Well, I mean, she probably is. Bound to have got on some of them for some reason. Have you got your expensive watch on, Silverhair? You got your Walmart watch on? Ah, yeah. So I see.
Look at it.
Does it play a tune? Take a picture of his flipping watch.
Can you hear it?
Yeah, I can. How's double 66s doing? Haven't heard. I've been busy.
You heard he's having to go for orthostatic surgery. He's getting his gallbladder removed.
Oh, he hasn't had it done yet.
As of 5 days ago, no, but that was the last time I think any of us had him in a hangout. It was maybe 4 or 5 days ago. Now, he did go in and have the stone, I don't know, manipulated somehow so that he could pass, you know, fluid.
All right.
Yeah, it was kind of graphic how he was describing his experiences. Everything was coming back up. Yeah, gallbladder is a nasty organ, man. I've had gall pain in my past. You really gotta like watch what you. Some people like me have to watch what we eat.
Yeah. Yeah, it's high fat food, doesn't it? It upsets your gallbladder.
Yeah, like milk, you know, berries, and red meats, that kind of stuff. Ice cream was my sin of choice. I mean, I used to go through a gallon of Breyers ice cream.
All right, all the good stuff. Yeah, well, all the good stuff's bad for you, Silver Siren. We all know that.
And then I filter all my water using a quality filter because those cheap ones on the refrigerator. It was something about the tap water when I was living in Florida. That stuff just really got to me. Every other week I would have some sort of pain that way. It's really no fun.
Oh, blimey. I'm just looking at your link, NAPC. That's pretty pricey, isn't it?
Yeah, that's for $0.50. I saw it the other day and thought of him.
Yeah, that's not even slabbed.
No.
You want to get one slabbed. I tell you what, the one guy that was in 30 minutes ago, his name is Chiga. Yeah, the guy that his name is George. He has a couple of them. He just got an MS-67, so he also has, I think it's a 60. Not George, Gary. Yeah, Siren has it, correct me. So anyway, he has a lower grade, a 64 or a 65, that's slab. That looks really good as well, and he's selling it for $250 USD.
It's a nice looking coin.
It is, yeah, I like the wagon.
FT Ideas bought one a couple weeks ago as well. I don't have that one myself yet. I got quite a few of the other ones lately.
You're going to have to get one, aren't you?
I will eventually. There's a couple more I want to get before that one, though.
This is going to be that easy.
Some of them just really expensive, like my Cincinnati 50-cent piece. I love that one. With the harp player on the back. But you really want to see an expensive one, NAPC? Type in Old Spanish Trail half dollar. It's a really cool one with a cow skull on it, like, you know, because it's going through Texas and all.
How do you spell real?
Real?
Yeah.
Or real. Yes. Gives the right context.
Oh, yeah. I see it.
R-E-A-L-E-S.
I thought he said real, but I think you meant the Spanish trade trail half dollar, the
1935. Yeah. That one, really nice one, but man, that's pricey.
Yeah, $2,000.
I've seen them for less.
Yeah, there's some on here for $1,500.
And then you really want to see an expensive one, Hawaii half dollar.
You want to see an expensive coin, click on the link I put.
I saw that. That's crazy, Brian, for a modern coin.
Why is it $20,000?
I think there were only 30,000 made.
$20,000.
$20,000 for what?
For a bullion coin. Oh, no, it's the proof.
I'll check the population.
What, 96 Eagle or 95 or whatever?
95.
Yeah, 95.
It's a quasi noomie.
Trouble is, we're all a bit concerned about NGC now, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was an eye-opener, that Salivate Metal video.
What do you do?
He put up a video on the production quality issues on the crocodile coin. There's like ding marks on it, and then they graded it at 70, and it's supposed to be perfect, right? But no, they said, oh, we'll let those things go. We're going to still call it a 70.
Yeah, I think BSO made a video on that before you did.
Oh, BSO did that too?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Well, in relation to that, yeah.
Yeah, he did it, and then Salivate bought one just to see as an experiment, and when it came, it was all fucking dinged up on the inner rim or something.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Yep.
Someone told me once that the NGC and PCGS won't grade rounds. They'll only grade government issue. I think they should stay away from grading fucking bullion if they're going to do that.
They're just
grading at 70. That's a cash grab.
All right. NGC is saying that that coin Brian put up is $18,000. And there's 362 graded at 70.
That's not a very small population.
Too much money for a piece of silver.
Yeah.
Especially a proof, you expect it to come at least to 70 or 69, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
There's 3,841.69, but only 362.70s, so go figure.
Yeah, but 362 at 70 is still quite a high number, isn't it? 362.
Yeah, that is a lot. For some reason, they're putting a lot of value on this.
I could understand if there was only like 50 graded at MS70 or PF70, rather.
The road sign I just bought, the koala, I don't have the website up right now, but I bought it from the Royal Australian Mint, and when they describe the coin, they describe it as they only release, like, the perfect coins.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it right. Like, when they sell you that coin, they guarantee it to be perfect, basically. So, a coin like that, why the fuck, it's a modern proof or whatever, why would you have modern proof graded? It should be 69 or 70, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you got a point there, so sorry. What's Mr. V put up there?
That's the population report. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but I put the link up.
Oh, I see. You can put in the number and verify.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, like you say, 362. Does it say how many were minted?
That's funny, Brian. That's like Silver Hair's coin.
I think Brian said total was 30,000 minted.
Graded tuna coins. Yeah.
Oh, anybody get those tuna coins? I got two.
Rocky.
Rocky got some?
Rocky didn't like his, man. He said they're all banged up. Someone just uploaded a video, though, and he said his looked perfect.
Really?
Yeah.
Mine's a little banged up, you know. It's not the nicest coin for a brand new coin, so, you know, but I'll keep him just because he has a tuna on it.
They do come in tubes, right? So at some point, the coin has to be dropped into a tube with a bunch of other ones. So
yeah,
you'd expect some dings, I guess. The goat's next year, Brian. You got to wait till October, September or October.
Yeah.
A few goats are out now.
Well, the Tokelau goat is out, but, you know, a little expensive.
Jesus, that's a little early, isn't it?
Yeah, it's we're still in the year of the horse, man.
Yeah, that's hype.
Well, the Canadian 100 for 100, is that Brian?
Canadian 100 for 100 as the ram.
I don't have any of those Tokelaus. I did pick up another one of those ghost chicks, though, the ghost bride.
Did you?
Yeah.
I think that's pretty cool, that ghost. It's a shame they didn't do it in silver.
Yeah, I searched every post office, and I could only find one more. And the last post office I went to, I said, I want that coin. If there's another one behind it, I'll take it, too. And he's like, oh, you want all of them? I was like, how many do you have? He said, oh, I got a lot. I was like, right on. And then he went through the drawer. He's like, nope, I guess I sold them all.
What, the ramp?
No, the fucking ghost bride.
Oh.
Thing is, I buy it and think I'm going to fucking flip it, but you know what? I probably just won't. I think I'd rather give it to, like, the kids or something. Like,
to scare the crap out of them.
Yeah. No, I just have the carded Silver Siren. I couldn't find one in the case. But the carded one comes with the stamp. Doesn't sound like fun at all.
Mm. Actually, I haven't talked about that. I haven't heard from Fine Silver Argent for a week or so. Is he still lurking around?
Who?
Fine Silver Argent.
I saw some comments on other people's channel. Maybe he's on vacation.
Maybe. I had a message from him and he sounded as though he wasn't well.
Oh.
Well, that was over a week ago, I think. Go to a party on a Sunday night.
He's hardcore.
Yeah. Don't know. Don't know, Silver Siren.
Yeah, there's lots of US coinage on there, so here's a bit of British coinage for you. The £2 coin.
Is that guy wearing like a kick-ass hat?
Yeah, it is. Isambard Kingdom Runel.
Are those £2 silver?
Yeah, silver, yeah.
Because I have one, and I didn't know it was silver, so I just fucking put it somewhere.
Yeah, that's what our silver proofs look like. Pretty shiny. You could shave in that. If you wanted to look at the coin.
Did they make a non-silver one? No.
Yeah, I think there is, yeah.
Oh, okay.
They're easily distinguishable.
Yeah, but mine might be a non-silver.
It's very difficult to show coins that are so highly reflective, isn't it? When you see the camera behind.
Now Brian's at it with the camera.
Yeah, you don't want to see that side. You saw that side a minute ago on the other coin. There you go, there's your other little polar bear silver siren.
Come on.
Okay.
It's obviously where they got the inspiration from the bullion coin, do you think?
Well, this is about a polar bear coin.
I'm kind of pissy at the Royal Canadian Mint right now for not releasing the quarter ounce Arctic Fox in the gold.
All right. Where did FT drop in then? I didn't see him there a minute ago.
Sneak in.
Snuck in while I wasn't looking. How are you?
Good.
I'll drop out if you want the Silver Siren.
Oh, the Road Sign series. We discussed that last night.
Yeah.
Leave it to the Aussies. Make a Road Sign coin.
I'm waiting for the stop sign or the yield sign.
Yeah, I'm hoping for a stop sign, actually.
Or construction head, or I don't know.
How many fucking signs could they have?
Well, there's thousands of them.
Yeah, I know, but like with ones with animals on it. Well, I guess there's lots in Canada too, I guess. Moose and deer and elk and caribou.
We have the mile marker series next.
One.
Two.
Retro buffer.
But never end.
people will confuse the mile marker for the face value.
That's not a bad price, is it, that Buffalo Bar, is it, for $24.23?
You can inscribe your username, say Cyber Curtain Twitcher, on the back for extra $5.
Exactly.
So 1 month, one-month sale, I think that's it.
Oh, you got the token of Pegasus there, FT.
Yes.
Have you just got that, or have you had it a while?
I've had it for, I don't know, a few months.
Oh, right. That's, I have seen it then, as I did know.
It's a nice finish.
They are very nice. They're proof, aren't they? Reverse proof.
Mm-hmm. Did you get your slab binder folder thingy?
Me?
Yeah, I remember you were talking about how to store your slab coins.
Oh, what? You haven't seen that?
I remember you talking about it, but I never got to see it.
Come on. Where is
magical binding.
That's a nice way to organize. You can see the front and the back. And if it's five sheets?
There's four.
Four?
I mean, you could get a thicker binder and put more in it. You can buy the sheets just by themselves.
And where'd you get this one from, Amazon?
Yeah.
I like that.
I don't remember how much it was. It was like maybe 30 or 35 for everything. But yeah, I think you can buy the sheets for
$5.
Yeah, $5 or $6 a piece, I think maybe. Yeah, but this fucker's full though.
Yeah, you got a lot of the Silver Eagles, man. That's awesome.
That's a complete date set, 86 to 2014.
That is a lot of value right there.
Can't really get it all in picture. Most of them 69s, probably 10 of them are 70s, another 10 or 15 are decans.
Cool.
Or ultra cameos.
You have the 1995?
Yep, 95 decam right there.
70?
No, 69.
69, yeah, we just saw a link. Brian posted up. 95-70 was $20,000.
That's not the right one, though.
Yeah. Oh, okay. That was the proof.
The 95W, there's only 30,000 of them.
Right.
So that's why. So who knows what the population of 70s is. You can look it up.
He just looked it up. It was like 300 something. 362.
Well, it's not super rare, I suppose.
It's not, but people want them. That's why the price went up.
Yeah, they want to complete a set, you know.
Right.
They want all the rarities of American Eagles. all the varieties.
It might be the end of that one, you know, if they release the new one next year.
I hope so.
And maybe they'll switch the mint as well. Maybe they'll start making them in Denver.
With a D mark on it?
Yeah. Carson City Mint, they're going to start that up.
That buffalo looks like a proof buffalo. Is this a regular buffalo?
I don't know.
They made a reverse proof gold, right? So I'm like wondering if they ever made like a proof or a reverse proof silver.
That's just generic. There's no maker on this. Or, I mean, that's from a private man.
Right.
It's a bullion round. It's not from the U.S. government.
Right.
Yeah.
But very popular.
Doesn't even have a date on it.
Yeah, some do, some don't.
Starting to tone out.
Oh.
Everything's toning out. That's got tone on it. That does.
How old are they?
That one's cleaner. This that's a 2012. That's a 12. This is an 87. It looks pretty clean.
Nice.
This dragon's got tone spots all over it.
Polish it?
No. I'm going to let it go, man. It'll turn into a rainbow and triple the price. What I got here. Those are all eagles.
Very good silver. Yeah, zombie for a penguin. My eagles all look pretty good.
This is my newest piece. It's 10th ounce Libertard. So small.
Yeah, I nearly bought one of them the other week. I think that's what it was. I missed out.
Elvis coin?
Yeah, it's up for trade if you're interested.